I want the students to feel like this is their home away from home. This is their community, a warm, loving, joyful atmosphere that they're coming to every day.
Our kids are proud students of Cincinnati Classical Academy, and they come home every day with the joyful stories of a wonderful day spent in the school.
My favorite thing about teaching at Cincinnati Classical Academy is engaging with the students with curriculum that actually develops who they are as people.
The formation of strong moral character is essential and really guides our curriculum.
Our mission at Cincinnati Classical is to develop the minds and nourish the hearts of our students through a integrated classical liberal arts and sciences curriculum with instruction in moral character and civic virtue. All of our students recite the student pledge. As a member of the classical community, I am respectful, responsible, and honest. I seek to know the truth, to do the good, and to love the beautiful. I'd like to think that we are putting that into action each and every day.
Every day on any court, in any situation with PE, the students are encountering the challenges of fatigue and competition. And within both of those spheres of influence is infinite opportunities to try to form their character.
The boys just really seem to enjoy it. They're engaged. It's affecting them at home. They're playing outside more. We are already kind of restricting the amount of TV they were allowed to watch, and it used to be a bit of a fight, and now it's not.
We're forming their moral imagination. So we get to talk about, would you do this in this setting? Can I be as brave as Pinocchio can be and rescue my father from the belly of the beast? They get to put on those shoes and explore that world, and I get to explore those worlds with them. What we learn in our classrooms safeguards the innocence and childhood that the children get to have.
It's important what the students are learning, when they learn it, and how it integrates with the other courses. So a student might be reading the narrative of Frederick Douglass. That will go along with the history course. They might be studying the Civil War, studying late 19th century American paintings in art class, and learning about Civil War music in the music class.
They really embody what they're performing and experience history in a deeper, fuller way.
What makes the classical curriculum unique is its return to the truest and most original form of what it means to receive an education. The root word of education means to lead forth.
So we believe in teacher-led classrooms. We have teachers who are moral leaders in the classroom, instructional leaders in the classroom. The students are the ones who are learning, but without a masterful teacher, the class is basically ineffective. We have an incredible curriculum, but without the teacher, that curriculum kind of falls flat.
We want to make sure that they are liberated, that's what liberal arts means, liberated to learn, grow, and explore the world through truth, through goodness, and through beauty.
They are teaching our students with an interactive approach, using engaging instructional techniques such as Socratic questioning, class discussions, choral responses. So as you walk through our school, you will see a lot of the teachers engaging directly with the students all day long, from kindergarten onward. It inspires their intellectual curiosity.
They're talking about what they're learning about in school. They're helping each other with math. They're reciting poetry. My kindergartner is reciting poetry. It's just very beautiful to see that. We equip and impress students with beautiful poetry, literature, and ideas that we hope they will carry with them for the rest of their lives.
We don't just want students who can read. We want lifelong readers, and we want lifelong writers. Students who are able to string together beautiful words into beautiful sentences, into beautiful stories.
Stories shape us, they shape who we are, they shape our imagination and our wonder, prompted by great literature and the great stories that we read all the way from kindergarten through 12th grade. We are asking for students to grapple with big questions and imagine some of the greatest things.
To learn to read and to learn to write sets our students up for success. But we also believe strongly that reading the classics of children's literature, learning about the history of the world, the history of the United States, is very important to kind of have that cultural background as they move forward.
Seeing those sparks of wonder and imagination and curiosity just come alive. They want more, they want to learn more. The stories that they read are age old, have been loved for generations.
Having a music program where the students can live out what they're learning makes all the difference in all of their classes. When you imitate courage, you're living out that courage in your body and your mind in a way that builds character like nothing else. It's different when you sing the words of a courageous person. It's different when you
think about justice, you don't just think about justice, you sing about how you're going to make a difference in the world.
So we're challenging students not just what they can do with their bodies, but what they can do with their mind and their character. And that whole picture is what really makes a classical program.
We feel immensely blessed to be part of Cincinnati Classical Academy. This school is very structured, very organized, very disciplined.
We've been really impressed with the teachers and the curriculum.
You can see the passion in everybody who works at Cincinnati Classical. They're all aligned on the same mission.
I daily encounter a vision that is shared by all the faculty, always centered on our mission for our school and on the well-being of the students.
The administration, staff and faculty, the students, and even the parents are all a part of something greater than themselves. This is important to the educational process, I think, and developing a community that isn't just looking at oneself, but is a part of the greater good.